Good afternoon and welcome to the final concerts of Senior Sims 2022. My name is David Upham. I am an orchestra director here at Sims, and I also direct the orchestra at UNH during the school year. I want to just start with a couple quick thank yous. I want to say, first of all, thanks to Music and Arts, the series of music stores, for the generous support of Sims every year. They give us, they loan us instruments, folders, various things that make it happen. We couldn't do it without their support. So I'd like to take a moment to thank them publicly now. Thank you, Music and Arts. And on behalf of myself and my colleagues, we want to thank you, parents, for allowing you students to join us for the last week and a day. It's been a real joy and a real privilege. As I told you, the audience for orchestra, I think they're going to be going home very tired, but very happy, and hopefully musically fulfilled. So thank you for joining us, and we hope to see you at Sims 2023. If you didn't receive our email from earlier this week, our camp nurse has requested, if possible, to be masking. We've had a spike of some instances of COVID. So if you have that and you're comfortable with that, our camp nurse has requested that. Today you will see the pieces programmed on the screen up behind me and the students. There is no printed program, going more digital these days. Later this week you'll receive a link in an email to a shared folder where there will be all the documents for this, and I believe some, perhaps even some recordings, different memories from camp. So take a look for that in an email later this week. And last announcement is, after the performance, if you would exit and go back out front and then come around, it is by far best if you plan to meet your students out in front of the building. They know where to go. It's quite busy back here. And if you come into the building to try to meet the students, it may not be as successful as just waiting out front. So we ask for your cooperation on that. Finally, it's my privilege to introduce the conductors for today. Dr. Andrew Boyson is our director of wind activities and is going to be starting his 25th year at UNH. Many of these students may have perhaps also have performed one of his compositions in their band back home. The program opens with co-director Casey Speed Goodwin. I was going to do the first piece, and Casey is our director of athletic bands. It includes the Wildcat Marching Band, the Beast of the East Pep Band, and also directs one of our concert ensembles, the Symphonic Band. So without any further delay, I'm tired. Please help me welcome the Sims Concert Band and Ms. Casey Speed. Percussion changes between pieces, so I'm just going to talk for a minute here while they change things over here. You may have noticed a little bit of an unusual element in that first piece, and actually there's kind of an unusual element to pretty much everything on this program, and that's kind of what unifies this program in a way, is kind of these little surprises that are within each of these pieces. That first piece included a part for iPad, and Ollie was playing that back there. So that was some of the unique sounds you were hearing in the middle of that. And that piece was actually composed by Erica Spano. Erica was actually Professor Goodwin's predecessor here. She led the marching band here for 3 years and has become really widely known as a composer and conductor around the country. So the second piece is entitled Into the Silent Land. This is by Steve Danu. I just want to read you a little bit of the program note from this so you have maybe a sense of where this piece is coming from. On December 14th, 2012, 20 children and 6 educators were killed by a gunman at Sandy Hook Elementary School in Sandy Hook, Connecticut. Having grown up in Sandy Hook just a mile from the school, this is where I attended grades 3 to 5. For the past several years, I have thought about writing a piece of music that would reflect on this tragedy, but I struggled to know where to start. Even after beginning to sketch out ideas for this piece, I felt unsure of where the piece should go and what it should communicate. In an effort to find a clearer sense of direction, I searched for poetry that reflected how I was feeling. When I came across Remember, a moving poem by Christina Rossetti, I found the direction I was looking for. Through the simple act of remembering, not forgetting that this happened, not forgetting these children, not forgetting the grief that their families must feel, I realized this is what I wanted and needed to communicate through music.
Remember me when I run away, climb far away into the silent land. When you can no more hold me by the hand, remember me. Thank you.
mention a couple of other thank yous. I know Dr. Upham was clear with some stuff at the beginning, but I also want to add a little bit to folks he mentioned. We have some folks that are helping us with the horn section today. Devin Dyer and Don and Tom, can you guys stand up? Thank you. Is helping us in the soon. Annie, can you stand up? I want to thank Missy LaBoy for all they did to help with the percussion section coordinating. You can tell it was a lot of coordinating for the percussion section. So Missy, come on over and say hi. Thank you to Casey Goodwin for sharing the program, sharing the concert band with me this year. Casey and I have talked together a long time and been friends even longer than that. And I admire her so much as an amazing teacher and one of my best friends. And so it's been an honor to have this program shared with her. And the most important thank you to all of you folks. This is from both Professor Goodwin and myself. We love this opportunity. Thank you so much. You were awesome. So. If you were at any of the earlier concerts, we're celebrating our 75th anniversary. We've commissioned works for all of the kind of the major ensembles. There was a jazz premiere last night, an orchestra premiere this morning. We're going to have another one now, and then a choral premiere later this afternoon. It's been really exciting to have the composers here with us. And as soon as I knew we were going to do this, the first person that I thought of was Dan Buckvich. Dan is internationally known as a composer, but he actually comes and teaches at Sims with us every year and has for longer than I've been here. We were trying to figure it out. It's got to be 30, 35 years. So he's a staple at this camp and on this campus. And so it was really cool to be able to bring him back, have him write something for us, and to spend time with us on the piece during the course of the camp. So I'd like to invite Dan to the stage to tell you just a little bit about his piece.
Thanks, it's great to be back at Sims for my 38th summer. Time flies when you're having fun. So, Dr. Boysen called me in the spring and he said, we'd love to have you write a piece for the 75th anniversary. And I, you know, I'm so humbled that you would ask me to do this. It's so cool. And that everybody would work so hard. We've had some great rehearsals. It's been fun listening to everybody work on this crazy thing. So, I don't want to say too much about this piece, other than thank you. I will tell you this, though. We went down into the archives, and we found a recording of the very first Sims concert, 75 years ago. And so we'll start with that recording and see where it gets us.
Thank you.